A great device can harm people. Let me repeat that. A great device has the ability to harm people. Okay, I wanted to dedicate a full video to this because I get asked this all the time, and it's facial fat loss with devices. And I know this happens, and I know some people are traumatized by it. It is devastating when it occurs, and a lot of people say, well, this couldn't have happened. It couldn't have happened to you. It doesn't happen. Certainly it can. Heating can remove fat from the face. And what am I talking about? What are the top devices that people say this or claim this with? Ultrasound, so high frequency or focused ultrasound, hifu, ulthera, which is different slightly than hifu, but people categorize it the same. RF is one that you hear all the time. So RF microneedling, radio frequency microneedling, the needles go into the skin, they're hot. They can be the length of the whole needle going in to about 3.5 millimeters is normal. Some do go deeper. Some are more shallow. I don't like those. But think of 3.5 millimeters that's into the fat layer, and they heat up. Either the entire needle heats up or just the tip. Okay, I use personally the ones where just the tip heats up so you don't get heat the rest of the way. And that because that's less controlled, in my opinion. So that's RF, and then RF from the outside. So you get treatment, Exalis would be one that you hear about. There's so many on the market, and a lot of home gamers have DIYs, do it yourself at home. This is where the transducer, it's usually bipolar, meaning the heat goes from one to the other head of the device. So there's a positive and negative, and the electricity goes through one side to the other. Unipolar means the energy goes through the body, usually to a pad on the back. So these are heating devices. Think of it that way. And so many people say, it made me look worse. It looked good for 4 months, but then I lost all my fat. I had more wrinkles. There's a couple reasons for this, and I'm going to go through one, two, three. Number one, A, maybe the device didn't cause it, but if you come in at 48, and the estrogen's just about to go down, and it plummets. By 49, people look much older, meaning more wrinkles, more fat changes in the skin. So it could be coincidence, meaning it was going to happen anyway, and you need more of those treatments because there's so much skin elastin loss, collagen loss, fat changes around the menopausal years. It's hard to keep up for those who aren't on hormone replacement. Okay, so that's one. Number two, it absolutely could occur. Heating will either shrink the fat, depending on how it's used, or it'll kill the fat. And you don't really make more fat cells. Fat cells, you have a finite amount for the most part. There's exceptions. They expand and they contract for a living. People get bigger and then they lose weight. It's not like you're multiplying fat cells. So when you lose the fat in your face, it's gone. I want the facial fat gone here and here because we know fat compartments now expand and contract. They grow with age, meaning they don't grow in the number of cells, but they grow in the bulk. Because you'll know, you get this and you get this. That's how we age. It's complex, but the fat is one. So the fat that's gone, yes, you can kill fat. It absolutely can happen. Now, one of the things you guys are going to ask me is, hey, which device is best? And I lose my mind. I can't, I answer it all the time, I do. But here it is. It's less so about the device being bad than the provider. And I'm not coming down on the providers who do it because there's positives and negatives. You can go to someone very aggressive and you can go to someone who's not aggressive enough. But in the middle, you don't want to go to someone who hasn't done 100 to 200 of these procedures. That is the key. So whether you had Ulthera, whether you had Morpheus, whether you had Scarlet, whether you had all of the other microneedling, Genius, Infinity, the person operating the device is going to be the most important thing that you could do to prevent side effects, facial fat loss and problems, not the device. A great device can harm people. Let me repeat that. A great device has the ability to harm people. Why? I want to harm the fat. I want to harm the fat here, here, and here, but I don't want to harm the fat up here. I don't want to harm the fat here, and I want to harm the fat down here, meaning get rid of it, but I don't want to get rid of the fat here. So you see, by the settings that I'm going to put on that device, it's going to determine whether I harm the fat or not. If you have someone that turns on the device, da 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 da, and then they treat the face and the whole face the same, there's no fat in the forehead. We got to keep every little bit of fat. I hate injecting foreheads. It's dangerous. But I want this fat to be tightened, to be gone, to be removed, and to sculpt that lower face. So forget the device. There are bad devices, but in general, the devices that are FDA approved and that are being used should be able to harm you, because I need to take it to the settings to harm the fat, and then I need to have lighter settings and more superficial settings to keep the fat in certain areas. And that's one of the problems with home gamers and DIYers. I'm all about it. However, if you're only treating one face and you get this device, how would you possibly know? When I'm looking at a face, I look at hundreds of faces in a week, and I'm studying, I'm talking to my colleagues, we're talking about good settings, bad settings, just like I did a video recently about three places not to put Sculptra. That's based on 20 years, 15 years of doing Sculptra. I don't learn that with two patients. So facial fat loss can occur. I want you to keep all those things in mind. The facial assessment that your provider does is the most important part of it. Their experience is next, and getting real products, real devices, and that comes with paying likely the price tag for that in most cases. Stay tuned here. I hope that helps. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.